Namaste children, welcome back to the session. In the last class we have discussed the new chapter called polynomials, and we also come across whether an algebraic expression is a polynomial or not. Even we have discussed the types of polynomial based on degrees. So today in this session we are going to study the new concept called division of polynomials. Division of polynomial by polynomial is similar to that of division of numbers. For example, 24 divided by 4. If I do the normal division, so 4, 6, 24 equal to 0. And here the another one more example, 25 divided by 4 means 4, 6, 24, and the remainder we get here is 1. In both the cases you can observe here the remainder is 0 and here the remainder is not 0, means it is 10 to 0 as the remainder and here it is 10 non-zero remainder. The same fashion of dividing even in the polynomials also. So now let us study the division of polynomial by a polynomial. In that there are two cases. So first we'll study the first case, that is division of a monomial by a monomial. So in this case let me take an example, that is divide 20x cube by minus 2x square. That is divide 20x cube by minus 2x square. So this kind of question can be done by applying exponential laws also. So 20x cube divided by minus 2x square. So if anything is not there, plus sign. We know that plus divided by minus is nothing but minus. 2 ones are 2 tens are, first we'll cancel the numericals, I mean coefficients, 10, then apply the exponential law, a power m divided by a power n is nothing but a power m minus 9, a power m divide a power n is equal to a power m minus n, then we'll get minus 10. X to the power of 3 minus 2 is nothing but 1. This is how we can do when the division of monomial by a monomial is given. If the division of a polynomial by a monomial, that we'll discuss now. So if we go with the second, that is division of polynomial by a monomial. We know that polynomial means, poly means many and nomial means terms, that is an expression consisting of many terms is nothing but a polynomial. So that is, if a one term then we call it as monomial, two terms an expression called as binomial, three terms an expression called as trinomial. If the expression is more than three terms we call it as polynomial. So to solve this division of polynomial by a monomial, there are three methods. The first method is dividing each term of the polynomial by a monomial. So for example, divide 6x to the power of 4 minus 8x cube plus 10x square plus 12x divided by 2x. So for this kind of solving, we have to divide the divisor to each term of the dividend of the polynomial. 6x to the power of 4 minus 8x cube plus 10x square plus 12x whole divided by 2x. Then 6x to the power of 4 divided by 2x minus 8x cube divided by 2x plus 10x square divided by 2x plus 12x divided by 2x. Then you can go for cancellation of numericals. 2 ones are 2, 2 threes are 6, 2 ones are two fours are, two ones are, two fives are, then two ones are, two sixes are. Then 3x to the power of 4 minus 1. The previous method, division of monomial with the monomial. Same method can be applied here. Minus 4x to the power of 3 minus 1. If anything is not there, the power is 1. Plus 5x to the power of 2 minus 1. Plus here xx get cancelled. So we will get only 6. Then 3x to the power of 3. Minus 4x square plus 5x power 1 plus 6. So this is the quotient after dividing this polynomial by this monomial. So this is one kind of solving polynomial by a monomial. The another type is factor method. Same example I'll take here. Divide 6x to the power of 4 minus 8x cube plus 10x square plus 12x by 2x. So factor method means, if possible, the given polynomial which is to be divided by a monomial in such a way that one of the factor is taken out as common and that factor is the same as the given monomial. You can see here the monomial is 2x. So 2 is the coefficient. So is it possible to take 2 as a common in the given polynomial? Yes, I'll take it 2 common. Then x is possible to take as a common? Yes, even x is possible. So take it outside. So this is the factor now. So left out is 2, 3 is a 6. 1x is taken. So the remaining 3x are there. I mean 3x to the power of 3 minus 2 is taken outside. So 2, 4 is a 8. Here x to the power 3 is there. So 1x is taken. Then x to the power of 2 remains inside. Plus, so 2 already taken. So 2 5 is 10. X square is there. X is taken outside. So only 1x is remaining. Plus here in 12x 2 is taken. So 2 6 is 12. And x is already taken as a common. So we should not write x. Whole divided by the divisor is 2x. Then this 2x get cancels. Then the quotient is 3x to the power of 3 minus 4x square plus 5x plus 6. So this kind of solving, I mean this method of solving is said to be a factor method. Now we'll move to the third method called as long division method. So in this method, two points to be remembered. Before going with this method, you have to remember these two points. The first point is both dividend and divisor should be in standard form. You have to convert dividend and divisor in standard form. The second point is continue the process of division until we get the remainder with degree less than that of divisor. So the degree of remainder should be less than the degree of divisor. Till there you have to continue the division or the remainder as 0. If we get the remainder as 0, we can stop the division. So here let me do by taking the example. Same example what I did for this method, that is divide each term of the polynomial by a monomial. The second method is factor method. Same example I'll take even in long division method also. So here the example is taken. So let me put it in their respective places. So 2x is the divisor and 6x to the power of 4 minus 8x cube plus 10x square plus 12x. So this is the dividend. Okay. Now how to do it? What to write in dividend place? I mean quotient place? Let me show to you. So first you have to take the first, confirm first, is it in standard form both? Yes. So first you take first term of dividend, that is 6x to the power of 4, and this you divide with divisor 2x, just like dividing monomial with the monomial. 2 1s are, 2 3s are, then here x power 1 we have, here x power 4. So like a power m divided by a power n is nothing but a power m minus n, that is 3x cube. So what we'll get, that you have to write in the quotient place, that is 3x to the power of 3. Now you multiply 2, 3 is 6, x into x cube is nothing but x power 4. That is, you have to multiply divisor with the first term of the quotient what you have written. Subtract. Since it is plus 6x to the power of 4, here 6x to the power of 4 minus. Cancels 0. Take the next term, minus 8x cube. So what is the second term? The second step is minus 8x cube. Then divide with divisor. 2x. 2 1s are 2 4s are. Then you'll get minus 4x to the power of 3 minus 1, 2. So the second term of quotient is minus 4x square. Then you multiply this term, what you have written, the second term with the divisor. Plus into minus is minus. 2 4s are 8. X into x square is nothing but x to the power of 3. That is, a power m into a power n is nothing but a power m plus n. Change the sign. The denominator, I mean the down what you are having, opposite sign you should write. That is, minus changes to plus. These both will get cancels. Take the third term, that is plus 10x square. Divide this with the divisor. 10x square divided by 2x. 2 1s are 2 5s are. Then you'll get 5x square minus 1. That is, x 2 minus 1 is 1. So you got plus 5x here. Multiply this term with the divisor. Plus into plus is plus. 2 5s are 10. Then x into x is x square. Change the sign, minus. So it also get cancels. Take the last term now. 12x. Then the fourth step is 12x divided by 2x. Same divisor. 2 1s are, 2 6 are, and this x get cancelled. So if anything is not there, plus 6. So plus 6. 6 plus into plus is plus. So 6 2s are 12 and x. Change the sign, minus 0. So here we got the remainder as 0. What is the quotient? Quotient is 3x cube minus 4x square plus 5x plus 6. Is it not the same quotient we got when we did with the factor method? Yes. Is it not the same quotient we got when we did with the divide each term by a polynomial by a monomial? Yes. So if you go with any method, the remainder quotient we get is same. Hope this is clear for you children, long division method. Now we'll move to worksheet 2, solving. So heading given, divide the following monomial by a given monomial. It's nothing but divide monomial by a monomial. First question, 6x cube by 3x square. Write it in normal form, 6x cube by 3x square. If possible, go for cancellation with their coefficient. 3 1s are, 3 2s are 6. Then x to the power of 3 minus 2, applying the exponential law, a to the power of m by a to the power of n is nothing but a to the power of m minus n. Then 2, x to the power of 3 minus 2 is nothing but 1. So we got the quotient as 2x to the power of 1, or simply you can tell it as 2x. Now we'll move to second question. So second question, minus 35x to the power of 4 by minus 7x cube. Write it in normal form. Minus 35x to the power of 4 by minus 7x cube. Minus by minus is nothing but plus. So 7 1s are, 7 5s are 35. Then apply exponential law. X to the power of 4 minus 3, that is a to the power of m, divide by a to the power of n is nothing but a to the power of m minus n. Then 5 x to the power of 1. This is the quotient. Now we'll move to third question. That is minus 5 z square by square root of 5z. So write it in normal form, minus 5z square divided by square root of 5z. So here minus by plus is nothing but minus. This 5 can be written as root 5 into root 5. And z square divided by root 5z. Let me tell you how. So root 5 into root 5 is equal to square root of 25. We know that 25 is nothing but a perfect square of 5. So like this we can write it. Okay. So this root 5 get cancels. Left out is minus square root of 5 and z to the power of 2 minus 1 is nothing but 1. This is the quotient, children. This is rough work. Clear? So the third question is also clear for you. We'll move to fourth question. So the fourth question given, 16p to the power of 4 by minus 6p square. Write it in normal form, 16p to the power of 4 by minus 6p square. Then plus by minus is nothing but minus. Cancellation possible, you can go 2 3s are 6, 2 8s are 16. So 8 by 3, p to the power of 4 minus 2, that is a power m by a power n is nothing but a power m minus n. Then minus 8 by 3, p to the power of 4 minus 2 is nothing but 2. So now we'll move to the fifth question. 4 root 2 y to the power of 3 by 3 root 2 y square. Then write it in normal form, 4 square root of 2 y cube divided by 3 square root of 2 y square. You can see here these both irrational numbers are same, get cancels, whereas this rational number is not getting cancelled, so we'll keep it as it is. 4 by 3, apply exponential law, a power m by a power n is nothing but a power m minus n, that is y power 3 minus 2. Then the final answer is 4 by 3 y to the power of 1. Sixth question, that is 3 by 4 p square by 4 by 3 p square. Both are p square, children, here. But remember, here the coefficient of p square is in rational number. Clear? So first you write it in normal form, 3 by 4 p square divided by 4 by 3 p square. Since both variable with their powers are same, so get cancels, 3 by 4, then this big division, I'll keep it as division only, 4 by 3. We know that the division changes to multiplication and the reciprocal of the number. 3 3 is a 9, 4 4 is a 16. So this is clear for you. Clear? So the first main finished, now we'll move to second main, children. Clear? So second main, divide the following polynomial by a monomial. So here, polynomial by a monomial, there are three methods. One, I told you, dividing each term of a polynomial with the monomial. The second method is factor method. The third method is long division method. Which is convenient for you, you can go with that method, children. So the first question, 6x to the power of 4 minus 24x cube plus 15x square plus 9 and divided it by minus 3x square. So here first let me write the given in the normal form, that is 6x to the power of 4 minus 24x cube plus 15x square plus 9 whole divided by minus 3x square. I'll go with first method, children, that is dividing each term of a polynomial with the given divisor. So 6x to the power of 4 divided by minus 3x square minus 24x cube divided by minus 3x square plus 15x square divided by minus 3x square plus 9 divided by minus 3x square. So any chance of cancellation with the coefficients, you can do it. 3 1s are 3 2s are 3 1s are 3 8s are 3 1s are 3 5s are 3 1s are 3 3s are. So be aware of the signs also, children. Here plus by minus is nothing but minus 2 into x to the power of 4 minus 2 exponential law. Minus by minus is nothing but plus 8 x cube minus 2, because we have here x cube and here x square. Plus by minus is nothing but minus 5. Here x square is same, get cancelled, so we don't get any variable here. Next, plus by minus is minus 3. Since x square is in denominator, so keep it as it is. So this is the quotient when you divide the given polynomial with the monomial. So now we'll move to the second question, children. The second question: 2 by 3 z to the power of 4 minus 1 by 3 z square minus 1 divided by 1 by 3 z. First you write it into normal form. That is 2 by 3 z to the power of 4 minus 1 by 3 z square minus 1 whole divided by 1 by 3 z. Now divide each term of polynomial with the monomial. 1 by 3 z minus 1 by 3 z square divided by 1 by 3 z minus 1 divided by 1 by 3 z. Be aware, children, here the coefficient are in rational number, right? So first you keep the rational numbers as it is, 1 by 3. Okay, then apply the exponential law. A to the power of m divided by a to the power of n is nothing but a to the power of m minus n, minus this 1 by 3, this 1 by 3 get cancelled. So z square minus 1 minus 1 divided by 1 by 3 z. Now 2 by 3, we know that division changes to multiplication, the reciprocal of the number 3 by 1, and z cube will remain as it is, minus 3 to the power z to the power of 1 minus division changes to multiplication, reciprocal 3 by 1 z. So this 3 get cancels, 2 z cube minus z minus, I mean this z power 1 you have here, so if it goes to the numerator it becomes minus 1. So 3 into z to the power of minus 1, or you can keep the z as it is in the denominator, like I'll show you here. 2 z cube minus z minus 3 divided by z. You can write like this the answer. This is all about second question. Now I'll move to the third question. Children, previous one was the third question. Now I am going to do the second question. First you write the given thing normally. Plus 22 x square minus 16 x cube plus 4 whole divided by 2x. Now minus 12x divided by 2x plus 22 x square divided by 2x minus 16 x cube divided by 2x plus 4 divided by 2x. xx get cancels, 2 1s are 2 6 are. This question is very important, children. Minus 6 plus 2 1s are 2 11s are. So 11 x to the power of 2 minus 1 minus 2 1s are 2 8s are. So 8 x cube minus 1 plus 2 1s are 2 2s are. 2 divided by x. The x is in denominator, children, here. So minus 6 plus 11 x to the power of 1 minus 8 x to the power of 2 plus 2 divided by x you can keep, or 2x to the power of minus 1. So now I'll move to the fourth question, children. Hope this is clear for you. I'll go to the fourth question now. So this question is very important, children. First you write normal. 2 square root 2 q to the power of 4 plus 4 root 2 q cube plus q square whole divided by minus 2 root 2 q square. This is very important for the examination point of view. 2 root 2 q to the power of 4 divided by minus 2 root 2 q square plus 4 root 2 q cube divided by minus 2 root 2 q square plus q square divided by minus 2 root 2 q square. So 2 root 2, 2 root 2 get cancels. Root 2 get cancels. 2 ones are, 2 twos are. And here q square get cancels. Left out is plus by minus is minus. Q power 4 minus 2 plus by minus is minus 2 q cube minus 2 plus by minus is minus. If anything is not there, then there is a factor 1 divided by 2 root 2. Because here I have written plus by minus is minus already. Again, don't take minus sign here. And variables get cancels. Clear? So which implies minus q to the power of 2 minus 2 q to the power of 1 minus 1 divided by 2 root 2. This is all about the second main, children. Hope this is clear for you. Now I'll move to the next main, that is third main. Third main heading, divide the following polynomial by a monomial. Polynomial is given and you should divide the polynomial by a monomial using long division method. So here the method is given. Which method you need to use? It is specified. Also write the quotient and the remainder. So after using long division, you have to write their quotient and also the remainder. So first question, minus 8x cube plus 6x to the power of 4 minus 4 plus 12x by 2x square. But keep remember, children, when you are going for long division method, I have told you to remember two points, right? So what are those two points? The first point is write both dividend and divisor in standard form. Clear? And the second point is you have to go on dividing until the remainder with the degree less than that of the divisor, or you may get the remainder as 0. Till there you have to divide it. So first convert into standard form. The highest power is 4. So 6x to the power of 4 minus 8x cube plus 12x minus 4 by, since it is a monomial, no need to arrange it in standard form. So put it in the respective places. 2x square. This method is very important for the next concept, children. So be alert. 6x to the power of 4 minus 8x cube plus 12x minus 4. Clear? So here for the rough work, first you take the first term of dividend. The first term of dividend is 6x to the power of 4. Divide with divisor 2x square. Then what is the quotient? 2 ones are 2, 3s are 6. So 3 x to the power of 4 by x to the power of 2 is nothing but x to the power of 2. So what you will get here, that should be written in the quotient, 3x square. After that you have to apply the multiplication concept. Multiply 3 2s are 6. X to the power of 2 into x to the power of 2 is nothing but x to the power of 4. Then subtract. So these two terms get cancels. Take the next term, minus 8x cube. Go for second step in the rough work. Minus 8x cube divide with divisor 2x square. 2 ones are, 2 fours are. So minus 4, x to the power of 3 by x to the power of 2 is nothing but x to the power of 1. So minus 4, x to the power of 1. So don't neglect the sign, children. Minus into plus is minus 4 twos are 8. X to the power of 1 into x square is nothing but x cube. Change the sign. Here you have minus. It will change to plus. So minus 8 plus 8 is nothing but 0. Take the next term. Plus 12x. So third step. Take first term. 12x divided by divisor. Clear. Then what it will happen? 2 ones are 2, 6 are 12. So you'll get 6 divided by x square power. X power 1 divided by x power 2. It's nothing but x to the power of minus 1. So here the power of remainder variable is lesser than the power of divisor. So you have to stop the division. So you can keep the minus 4 as it is now. So what is the remainder? The remainder is 12x minus 4 and the quotient is 3x square minus 4x. Clear? Here we did not get the remainder as 0, but the power of remainder, variable of power of remainder is lesser than the power of variable of divisor. Therefore, that ends the division. So now we'll go to the second question. So moving to second question, hope the polynomial is already in standard form. Okay, put it in their respective places. X to the power of 5 as a divisor and 5, x to the power of 10 minus 9, x to the power of 8 minus 9, x to the power of 5 plus 7x is the dividend. So rough work, the first term of divisor and dividend you have to take. First you take the dividend, 5 x to the power of 10 divided by divisor x to the power of 5. So here coefficient doesn't get cancelled, keep it as it is 5. X to the power of 10 by x to the power of 5 is nothing but x to the power of 5. So what we got here, 5 x to the power of 5, write it in the quotient place, 5 x to the power of 5. Now multiply, 5 ones are 5. X to the power of 5 into x to the power of 5, x to the power of 10. It's like a to the power of m into a to the power of n is nothing but a to the power of m plus n. Change the sign, minus, plus and minus get cancels. Next, minus 9, x to the power of 8. Take the second step, minus 9, x to the power of 8 divided by divisor x to the power of 5. Then we'll get plus by minus is nothing but minus 9. Then subtraction of the powers, you'll get x to the power of 3. Write it the same in the quotient, minus 9, x to the power of 3. Then multiply, minus into plus is minus. 9 ones are, if anything is not there, 1 here. So 9 ones are 9. X to the power of 5 into x to the power of 3 is nothing but x to the power of 8. Then change the sign, minus changes to plus. These both will get cancelled. Bring the second next term, minus 9 x to the power of 5. So the third step, minus 9 x to the power of 5 divided by divisor 1 x to the power of 5. Both get cancelled. Then left out is minus 9. So minus 9 multiply minus into plus is minus. 9 ones are 9. Then here we don't have variable, but here we have variable, so keep it as it is, x to the power of 5. Minus changes to plus, so minus 9 plus 9 get cancels. Then bring the last term, plus 7x. You can observe here, the power of the power of variable in the remainder is lesser than the power of variable in the divisor. Means the division should be stopped here. Clear? Then remainder equal to plus 7x. If you have any other term, that also you need to bring it and write the total remainder here. Okay. And the quotient is 5x to the power of 5. Quotient is this, children. Minus 9x cube minus 9. Now I'll move to third question. 5z cube minus 6z square plus 7z by 2z. So both are in standard form. Put it in their respective places. 2z into 5z cube minus 6z square plus 7z. So for the rough work, first step, first term of the dividend, 5z cube divided by first term of the divisor. Since divisor is monomial, So leave it. 5 by 2 doesn't get cancelled. Z. Here we have z and here we have z cube. Therefore, 5 by 2 z power 3 minus 1 is nothing but 2. So 5 by 2 z square. Now multiply. 5 by 2 into 2 is 5. Z square into z is nothing but z cube. Change the sign. If anything is not a plus sign, so it changes to minus. It gets cancels. Bring the next term, minus 6z square. So second step, minus 6z square divided by divisor 2z. 2 1s are 2 3s are. Then minus 3z square by z power 1 is nothing but z power 1. So minus 3z power 1. Z. Now multiply, minus into plus is minus. 3 2s are 6. Z into z is z square. So change the sign. Minus changes to plus. Minus 6 plus 6 get cancels. Then bring the last term, plus 7z. Then the step 3. 7z divided by 2z. So zz get cancels. Left out is 7 by 2. So plus 7 by 2. Multiply. 7 by 2 into 2 is 7. You can check here. 7 by 2 into 2. 2 2 get cancelled. 7. So 7 is written here. And no variable here. But here we have variable z, you write it. So if anything is not there, plus sign. So changes to minus. Get cancelled. 0. All the terms I have taken here from the dividend. So no term is left out. Therefore, the remainder equal to 0 and the quotient is 5 by 2 z square minus 3z plus 7 by 2. You might have observed in all the questions, children, I have changed the sign in the dividend. Right? Why we have to change the sign? Let me show you. So if I take 24 divided by 5. Then what you will write? 5, 24, 5, 4, 20. Then what you will do? You will do subtraction, right? So plus changes to minus here. Then 24 minus 20 is 4. You are changing the sign here? Yes, because of that reason only we are changing the sign in the dividend. You can observe in all the question I have changed the signs. So because of this reason only, children. That completes your worksheet 2. Clear? So we'll meet in the next class, children. Have a nice day. Thank you.